Hello everyone, we have known for a long time that the force of gravity and electromagnetism diminishes with the increase in distance. But this is not the case with the strong nuclear force. It is the property of the strong force that as the distance between two particles interacting via strong force increases, the force between them actually increases. This is completely at odds with the gravitational or electromagnetic force. But why does it happen so? Well, the answer to this lies in quantum mechanics. Now, there are four fundamental forces in the universe: gravity, electromagnetism, weak and strong nuclear force. According to quantum field theories, these forces are mediated by particles. The strong force is mediated by gluons, same as the electromagnetic force is mediated by a more familiar particle, a photon. Now, as the electromagnetic force has electric charge, strong force has color charge, though it has nothing to do with color in the visual sense. Now, the electromagnetic force has two charges, positive and negative, whereas the strong force contains three charges, three color charges, red, blue, and green. Again, it has nothing to do with color in the visual sense, or it hasn't had to do anything with actual colors. Now, the electromagnetic force is different to strong force in a way that the force carrier of the electromagnetic force, the photon itself, does not have the electric charge, whereas the force carrier of the strong force, the gluon, do contain the color charges. That means gluons can interact with each other while photons cannot. Now, these particles, quarks and gluons, electrons and photons, in the quantum field theories are described by excitations in their respective quantum fields. What are quantum fields? Well, we know that our universe contains different kinds of particles. For example, let's take the electron. We had previously thought that electron is a particle somewhere in space that has nothing to do with any other electron. But according to the quantum field theories, these electrons, or all of the electrons, are related in the sense that all of them are excitations of the electron field. The place where the electron field has a high enough value, we can observe an electron. This is the basic idea. Now, a key insight. In reference to the uncertainty principle, these fields can't have definite values. There is an uncertainty involved. So these fields always have fluctuations. These fluctuations can momentarily create particle-antiparticle pair that usually quickly annihilates again. The more their property matches with their real counterpart, the longer they exist. These are somewhat different to the normal real particles, so we have given them a new name. We call them virtual particles. Virtual particles transmit forces between matter in our universe. When we talked about gluons mediating their strong force and photons mediating their electromagnetic force, those were actually virtual gluons and photons. Now, a quark is an excitation in the quark field and a gluon is an excitation in the gluon field. Since gluons contain charges, there can be more than one type of gluons. As it turns out, there are eight types of gluons independent of each other. That means there are eight different and independent gluon fields, which all mediate as well as interact with the strong force. In a similar way, there are six types of quarks: up, down, strange, charm, top, and bottom. That means there are six different quark fields as well. Protons and neutrons, which we all are familiar with, themselves are composed of three quarks. A proton is made up of two up and a down quark, whereas a neutron is made up of two down and a up quark. A quark-antiquark pair can also exist, which we call a meson. Now, quarks inside a proton or neutron are bounded there because of the influence of the strong force. Since gluons themselves contain color charges, they can interact with each other. These gluons then constrain color fields to tube-like structures called flux tube that works like a rubber band. When not stressed, the force is very small, so quarks can move like free particles in a process called asymptotic freedom. But when quarks try to move apart, the rubber band stretches, thus force increases. The larger the pull of the quarks to move apart, the larger the strong force. Eventually, if we apply large enough energy, the rubber band breaks. Or in the case with strong force, eventually the energy supplied to break apart these quarks gets so much that new particle-antiparticle pair gets created. That means quarks are still bounded with these flux tubes. The energy supplied to isolate these quarks gets used up in creating new quark-antiquark pair. There is currently no way we can observe isolated quarks. This is what we call quark confinement. This is precisely the reason behind why we have not been able to observe any isolated quarks. They are always been observed in groups. This is also the reason behind the small length scale of the strong interaction. Okay, so that's all for today. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.